بالميامين هداتي من بني هاشم بخاتم النبيين أخي الوحي أبي.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم and welcome to Hadi TV's The Great Trust. It is true that we are from Allah and we will return to Him. And whatever belongs to us is His, is a trust of Allah to us, including our children. And we know that whatever comes from Allah is pure and whatever returns to Him should also be pure. So the responsibility of us, parents, caregivers, guardians in this time and era, have a responsibility of purifying our generation and our children to the utmost so that when they return to Allah, we are happy and satisfied and pleased with that. So our responsibility in this time and era is working hard on the inner souls of our children. And we know that the only way to achieve that purity, that inner purity, is keeping connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In our last few sessions, we discussed with our ulama the ways of keeping connected to Allah in looking at the household of the Holy Prophet and his family, and seeing how we can inculcate these Islamic values into the hearts of our children using special times in the day of our children, including mealtime, prayer, and bedtimes. To learn more on these Islamic values, we will welcome our ulama Razia Batullah Jafi to the studio. Assalamu alaikum, dear Alima.
Wa alaikum assalam, rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
And thank you once again for blessing us with your presence. And alhamdulillah, so far we have managed to learn a lot about inculcating the Islamic and religious values into the hearts of our children, which are so ready to accept whatever we give them. It may be from media, it may be from the environment, their school, their friends, or if it's from their house. Whatever is given to them, they will accept it. We all know that we exactly. As parents have seen it.
Yes.
And we know that Islam says that the children need to be given this Islamic teaching from a very tender age. How important is the role of religious training for them right now that will help them in the future, that will build their personality and character?
Yeah, alhamdulillah, we have discussed a lot about this very, very essential and important, you know, issue, which is the spiritual and the religious training, which is one of the very, I can say that important, you know, responsibility which Allah has put on the shoulder of the parents, because only giving the physical perfection and giving them secular education is not enough. We should realize that, you know, if we are just very careful about their, you know, physical health and food and nutrition and education without giving them spiritual, you know, good foundation,
training.
Especially because we are talking about, again, 0 to 7. I'm emphasizing a lot, I'm insisting a lot, because rarely parents give a lot of importance to this area
stage,
of time,
right.
Yeah, in this stage. So as we know that they can understand everything, not only they can't understand the religious training, even they enjoy more because it is near to fitrah,
right,
near to their
pure
nature.
That age,
yes.
Right.
So
less evils they have involved themselves in.
Definitely. So if you are giving them just education and nutrition without this fundamental
mm-hmm.
issue, which is spiritual training,
mm-hmm.
then sometimes they are more harmful for their, you know, society, because as we know, it's so common that, you know, in Farsi they say chundoz di bochara ghayat gazide tar barat kala, like if a robber comes with a lantern,
mm-hmm.
you know, will cause greater loss, because, you know, he knows which and how and when I should, you know, give
mm-hmm.
this kind of harm to my society.
Mm-hmm.
So
you mean educated robber, you mean an educated,
yes.
thief is,
yeah,
dangerous.
More dangerous,
mm-hmm.
definitely, because if you are sitting on the very key post without
mm-hmm.
having that faith,
okay.
and sincerity about
mm-hmm.
mankind, so you will not serve, you know, the society.
More harm than good.
Definitely. So doctors, teachers, principals, you know, like the rulers,
mm-hmm.
and even the, you know, even in law, if you good judges, if they don't have good like akhlaq and good training and then sincerity, you know, with, towards mankind, then they will misuse their post and even their you know, this degree and their, you know, their status. So mm-hmm. if we are just, you know, focusing on their education, because, you know, unfortunately most of the parents, because they're just watching in media and outside the society, just they're focusing and talking about education and nutrition. Yeah. You know, really, you know, we get to know the very, very importance of the religious training. Mm-hmm. That's why we can see where it's very obvious then where that we give a lot of our money, time, energy to other education and nutrition more than for religious, you know, mm-hmm. training and education. Why? Because like we have seen that, you know, we don't give that much importance to madrasa, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we don't have, we say we don't have choice, we know that our madrasa doesn't have any, you know, trained teacher, but mm-hmm. we don't care about it, but we never ever want to send our children to the, you know, school where the teachers are unqualified, right? You know, mm-hmm. and but about religion, we very easily we compromise it, right? But mm-hmm. what Islam is saying it's, you know, never ever be compromised about religion. So give your, you know, time and money and energy to religion first, then definitely religion itself is saying to give a lot of importance to science, to other knowledges, to, you know, all this nutrition and education, everything, if it goes under the religions, you know,
the
training,
umbrella,
yeah,
of religion, right?
Definitely. Mm-hmm. Then they will, you know, get more and more fruit from it,
right.
But again, I'm insisting the age which is, you know, we mm-hmm. should start the mm-hmm. training, religious training, is there from 0 to 7. Yeah.
So I was just looking, as you mentioned, that the age 0 to 7 is the most important. It's the foundational age. Whatever hard work we put in this age will affect in the following years, as we see with these little pieces of toys of mm-hmm. a child. If this could be the early age from 0 to 7,
yeah.
And we want to build anything on it, it would be good education, good school, and we see you can work with it, it'll go up a few ages, but in the end it has to trip,
yeah,
it
definitely.
Has to fall in the end.
That much important, this mm-hmm. you know, the, what you can say, that foundation,
right.
It
the
is,
base,
yeah.
It is, right?
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And that's why we have so much emphasis about this, you know, pre-age of the child.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, definitely.
True. So we see, and the best thing to achieve in this age is that spiritual connection to Allah, because
mm-hmm.
if they're connected to Allah, and then in their life they will not lack anything. They will always have a support to look up to look forward to take help,
exactly.
from, to seek refuge from, right?
Yes, definitely.
And also, as you mentioned, a very important point, that we parents of this age give a lot of emphasis and importance to education and nutrition. But Alamat, correct me if I go wrong, isn't there a piece missing? Don't they feel that once their child has achieved the best education, have gone to the best school, and they've had the best type of nutrition considering all the requirements for the day, but they still feel, end of the day, there's something missing in their life? You know, they feel that emptiness inside,
yes.
the heart, and still the children don't always,
exactly.
stay on the right path.
Yeah.
Then in the later ages, they are misled, they go on the wrong path. So I think the missing factor is that spiritual connection,
exactly.
right? They don't have spirituality.
Of course.
Just a few days ago, I was searching on spirituality for children, and believe me, that a lot of websites popped up which were giving spiritual training from other points of view, from other religions, like from Christianity, from Judaism. It was from the other point of view. That means even those people in the West, and those non-Muslim people, are also realizing the need of spirituality,
exactly,
in children.
Exactly,
because,
yeah.
it is a main factor for their building, for their
definitely,
growth.
Definitely, yeah, definitely. But I think we have rarely any good website about this topic,
mm-hmm.
you know. So inshallah, you know, the young mothers and our good viewers, if they have this skill, yeah, of good,
the talent,
you know, they're designer,
right? mm-hmm.
or good writer. So we have to do lot of, you know, work, because we have only one life. And we can't, you know, play with this life. We can't experiment at, okay,
can't
what will
risks,
happen. Yeah,
no time
no
for
risk
us.
At all, because only one. And if it goes this time, then we can't, you know, return it very easily.
Mm-hmm.
Never, ever. So that's why our Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam is, you know, keep telling us with very, you know, polite way, and they are giving this advices to us. Inshallah, we listen to them and act upon them. Yes, inshallah.
Yeah. Another thing, since we feel that this is the age, the parents from 0 to 7, when the child reaches the age of 3, 4, 5, they're hunting for a nice school for their child. At the same time, maybe they can hunt for a nice teacher for their child as well, Islamic teacher for their child.
Many parents, they say, we don't have any choice for Islamic
education. In the country, for example, if they live there.
So do you have any advice for them? What kind of choices they can have?
Well, as far as I know, they can always get some books and CDs from other Islamic countries, if it's in their language, or at least there. As far as I know, there's some good Islamic online courses as well for the Bulugh age, from 9 onwards or from 10 onwards. So if they want, they can always
private tutor.
Right, private tutor is the best.
Because we are discussing these all choices, because, you know, maybe some parents, they don't realize it. They say, we have one madrasa in our area, just we are sending there and nothing else.
No choice, right?
But if they don't have good teachers there, or if they're not satisfied from that madrasa, so if they have good environment, a religious environment in their house, then it can cover very easily. Otherwise, it's not enough at all. Mm-hmm. Then they can, you know, do the struggle of, you know, having a private tutor. So I can understand that you know, other education is very easier than this one, because we don't have any role model, we don't have any established centers for spiritual or religious education. So we have to do individually, so much struggle for it. So it's a jihad, it has sawab, and that's why our Prophet has said that, you know, in the last time, you know, the parents will do this kind of jihad, some of them, and some they don't, just they don't bother about their, you know, kids' religious you know, training and education, just they are thinking about their physical perfection. So inshallah, if they have very, you know, strong will and they want to do it, then inshallah Allah will provide them the best way, and Allah will show them, you know, the guidance.
Right, definitely. And we know that with everything, if you want help from Allah, you have to put in some struggle, put in some effort, and then definitely Allah provides a way for them. So with this, viewers, we will take a short break and we'll get back to you after. Thank you very much. Welcome back, our viewers, and back to our discussion on the training, the religious training of children. We know this time in age is a difficult one, since it is the last age that we say, the Akhir Zaman. And dua is a weapon of a believer. Which dua is the best to use in this time of need, when the parents want to bring their kids on the right path, and the children are on the tough part, because obviously the media, everything is so influencing. So what would be the best weapon for us right now?
Definitely, I think, you know, as we know about it, and we have just, you know, mentioned about it in one of our episodes, that the best dua for, you know, parents, it could be a dua of Sahih Fi Sajjadiyah, dua number 24. Mm-hmm. It's a very beautiful dua, and like whatever one parents can wish for their, you know, children, our Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, he has wished, you know, like, because it was his dua, you know, so he knows the best of the best, and whatever we want more than that is there. So, and how much, you know, calm and peace this dua can give to us, and not only that, even we can learn so many, you know, techniques of tarbiyah training, and so many knowledge we can get from it. As we know that our imam, because of some political situations, he wasn't you know, allowed to teach preach directly. So he, you know, had choose this beautiful way. So it's his teaching, it is his messages, you know, is giving this beautiful information to us. So and other thing which is very important is, even other traditions and ahadith, they are encouraging us that, you know, the parents that should pray for their kids, because one of the du'as which never ever Allah will reject and definitely Allah will inshallah accept it, it is the du'a of, you know, father for his child and du'a of parents for their children. And as we know, this is the hadith, you know, it says that four people's du'a, our Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, he's saying that four people's du'a never ever be rejected. One is, you know, father's du'a for his child. Second is if an oppressed person is doing du'a for against oppressor, and the person who has done his umrah, umrah is you know, very again one of the beautiful, you know, we can say ibadah, worship of Allah. And I know Zahra, some of my friends, you know, they are not that much well off, but whatever they have, they put and they collect the money, and they go approximately every year for umrah with their kids, just because of training of kids, they like to go for umrah and for ziyarat. So it's so important if our parents, you know, and my mothers and fathers, if they're listening, really, if they can afford, like they can afford means, you know, how much priority they are giving, you know, right. That is very important. Sometimes just we buy so many goals for our daughter, yeah, and put on like some investment for them, for their future. We are not thinking about their religious training in this specific age. If they are near 7 or you know, under age of 13, 14, we have to take them if we afford, yeah, because it's again, we have so much encouragement about umrah. So the person who has done his umrah, if you know, in his return way to his hometown, Allah will accept his all du'as. And the fourth one, the person who has fast and before the iftar and yeah, and near iftar time, Allah will accept his du'as. So when Prophet is saying, again, one another place Prophet is saying, you know, when the father raises his hand or mother for his child towards skies, heavens, so the du'a will cross the all the clouds and all the skies and heavens until it will reach near the throne of Allah, and then Allah will say to the angels that don't become an obstacle of this dua, because I want to accept it, you know. So that much emphasize we have for du'as, and we have to do du'a. And Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salam, he is saying in other place that da'watul walad as-salih li walidayhi wa da'watul walid as-salih li waladihi. Like both, from both sides, like if you know, parents are praying for his child, and if a child is praying for parents, but pious child and pious parents, yeah, if they are salih, this condition is there, then Allah will never ever reject this kind of dua. So this much emphasize we have from one hand.
It's encouraging to just know this, that Allah is ready to accept your dua, but just yes. Go and pray, just try to reach Allah, try to call him.
Exactly, yeah. So if we go towards the dua of Sahifa Sajjadia, as Imam Baqir Sadiq alayhi salam is saying, you know, parents should do dua for their children, and children can do dua for their parents. And for both Imam Zainul Abideen alayhi salam, he has done dua, you know, and both du'as are together. One is the first is because we have respect for our parents. So first dua number 24 is dua for parents, and dua number 25 is supplication for children.
Okay, so that dua number 24 is dua the children do for their parents.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And the next one is what the parents do for their children.
Yeah, so we are discussing about the dua which parents they do for their children. You know, so we can say the supplication for children. For children we are doing dua, yeah. And but Imam has done for his children, so we are learning from that. So this dua, as we know, it's not very long, but a bit, like it has near 35 sentences, yeah? And I think 13 small paragraphs it has. But I can say that if you don't want to recite all of you know, this dua, just I'm giving some information about this dua, because as I said that Imam wanted to give us some, you know, information, like some ilm and some advice. So it starts with this beautiful sentence, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allahumma munna alayya bi baqa'i wuldi wa bi islahim li wa bi imta'i bihim. The translation is so beautiful, like Imam is saying, oh Allah, be kind, you know, do ihsan on me, to me, through the survival of my children. Baqa, survival. Allahumma munna alayya bi baqa'i wuldi. Wuldi means children, yeah. Wa bi islahim li, it's so beautiful, like setting them right for me, reforming them for me. So the real target and achievement for parents is that islah, salih, from righteousness. Wa bi imta'i bihim, and then allowing me to enjoy them, to take pleasure from them. So it shows that Zahra, that there is deep connection between salah, righteousness, piousness, and enjoyment and taking pleasure. Like it's so beautiful. Like I love this sentence, and if I don't get time, just I recite this every day so many times whenever I get tawfiq. I say just Allahumma munna alayya bi baqa'i wuldi wa bi islahim li wa bi imta'i bihim. Like from just right from the birth time,
yeah.
I want to take that pleasure, I want to enjoy that time.
Right. But then Alima, what's the general concept, that you only take the pleasure from your child after they have matured, after they have formed into a proper, perfect individual, that is, they have reached their 20s, their 30s.
Really? No. But we have seen the character of Ahlul Bayt. Yeah,
right.
Because I'm training them from the, before their birth.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm giving them that religious training, spiritual training, and my love and my affection and everything for them. And I'm enjoying, because as we have mentioned, that Hubbul Atfal is the Afzalul A'mal, like loving the children is the best amal, even for prophets, even for A'imma alayhimus salam. So I'm, oh Allah, make my this job, as a fun for me, because I want to see you in my children, mm-hmm. and my kids. I want to make my this job so much holy, so much spiritual. I feel that I'm very connected with you by this, my responsibility. So this is so important, that we should enjoy our life, like with kids, with training them, with giving them good education. And how we can enjoy? The reply is there again. If we want to make them, on the right path. And if we are guiding them towards piety, yeah. So it starts from right after birth. So I have to start my religious training right after birth. And I have to take that pleasure from that time. Because, the way the children say La ilaha illallah, or, like my son, he goes to Lebanese school. So he knows Arabic. So it was his first Ramadan, after like he was 3 or 4, he started to understand the du'as, the meaning of du'as. Ya Mawla, Ya Mawla, Ya Antal Khaliq, Wa Ana Makhluq, all these very simple du'as. So I get so much pleasure by listening to him. So this kind of pleasure we can see, because of Islah, because of their good akhlaq, good, ethic, as mashallah, so many parents, they do. So Imam wants to say that pious children can, give a lot of, all the benefit goes for parents in this world or hereafter. They will take the pleasure, they will take the peace, and their children are very good manner, so again they are very humble, they are very respectful, positive qualities. If their children have, they, the benefit will go
to the parents.
Yeah. So that's why just I want to, say that, Hassan al-Baswari, he came to Imam Sajjad alayhi salam, because we are discussing the dua of Imam Sajjad. So he said, I don't like the, children, because they cause a lot of trouble for us. And if they are alive, so we are so worried about them. And if they get died, so then we get so much, they gave us so much grief. safe. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So both sides are trouble and trouble. You know, we don't want these kids and children. But look at the Imam's side, you know, and view and beautiful, you know, the way Imam is watching, how much positive it is. Imam, you know, Imam took very strong action, and Imam said, "Ghadiba wallah ni'ma shay al-walad." You are saying completely, you know, opposite, and everything is, you know, not correct. Wallah, with the swear by Allah, you know, how much emphasis Imam is giving. And then Imam is saying the best ni'mat and the best thing which Allah can give in this world is walad, is child. Then Imam is saying, in Aasha fa du'aun hadir wa in mata fa shafi'un sabiq. Like, if he is alive, then he, because of him, Allah is giving a lot of dua. Even, you know, he's, because I'm training him in the right way, so whenever he gets, you know, sick or uncomfortable, I will get all the sawab,
the reward.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Reward. So he's increasing and increasing lot of barakat and blessing in my life, number one. Number two, okay. If he dies, then I have sent, you know, best person who's doing intercession for me. The best intercessor is there and waiting for me. So I have sent sabiq, you know, before me, one intercessor is waiting on the door of Jannah for me. So in both sides, you know, we get,
win.
Yeah.
It's a win-win situation, you don't lose here.
Yes, mm-hmm. So that's why Imam is saying, wabi imta'ibi. This is the way of looking on the child in the eyes of Allah. And the way we look, it's completely opposite. You say, oh, you know, it's a big hassle. Oh, you know, poor lady, she has so many kids and all the day. She's, you know, just with them, no fun in life, nothing she's, you know, achieving. So we look at that negative way, but look at our Imam.
So we have given a very positive perspective to children and how their life and their that can mean to the children.
Definitely.
So this was just the first line, as you said, of the dua, and mashallah, that means you have such a big treasure in our books from our Imams.
Right? Yes, yes. And it means again that Imam is saying it's very pleasurable, but it's very tough too. Mm-hmm. Like, why? Because in next session he is saying that, you know, oh Allah, you help me. أعني على تربيتهم وتأديبهم وبرهم. I need your help because it's not an easy task. You know, so somehow we can say it's a tough kind of, you know, pleasurable thing. It's tough, mm-hmm. but it has a lot of pleasure too. So I will suggest to my, you know, viewers that just even they don't want to recite all the dua, just they can, you know, memorize this one. Allahumma munna aliyya bi baqa'i wuldi. Like you are doing the dua for their health, for their life, you know, physical dua.
Safety,
then
protection.
Yeah, this is physical one. Then bi islahihim, this is spiritual one. So after this, you know, if you have physical and spiritual perfection, then you will get the
benefit
the and the pleasure, which is bi imta'i bihim. So islah and baqa will give you imta', which is means pleasure.
Pleasure, right.
Then other you know, sentence is also very beautiful. Waj'alhum abraran atqiya'a busara sami'ina muti'ina lak. Then you know, it's again one of the you know, qualities we can say, the spiritual qualities, make them pious, fearing, insightful, hearing, and obedient towards you. Yeah, abrar, it's not an easy, you know, status, easy post. Atqiya, busara, sami'in, muti'in lak. ولأوليائك محبين مناصحين ولجميع عدائك معاندين ومبغضين. It says that loving and well disposed towards your friends and stubbornly resistant and full of hate towards all your enemies. And that is important, that when parents are saying that, oh Allah, you know, make them pious and make them away stubbornly, you know, from the enemies, your enemies. So we should, you tell them that what kind of enemies they have. It doesn't mean the outer enemies, mm-hmm. even the
enemy,
you know,
can be inside us, in our house, close to us.
Yes, definitely. Yeah.
So these are basically all the qualities that Imam is asking from Allah to instill instill into his children, into our children.
Exactly.
With this, our time does come to an end, unfortunately, but we will close up with these very few nice and interesting points that see Islam is not just saying to give them only spiritual food, just spiritual training, just Islam or religion. No, as we see in the Dua of Imam, the first thing mentioned is their physical security, and then comes their spiritual upliftment, and then gives us the benefit. So with this, we'd like to remind our parents that Islam is a religion that takes care of both the things, the physical and the spiritual aspect of our children. So must we parents look for the physical security of our child and also work on the spiritual upliftment for it. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.